Hello, I'm Paxton Wineshook, and I'm here with Mrs. Kerber. So, first question, what are you excited about for this school year?
Everything. I love being a Buccaneer. I love working with students. I love working with staff. I love attending events and helping students achieve their potential. So, everything.
Good answer. What do you love most about working here at Covington?
I believe the reason I got into education is the reason that I stay, and that's to work with students like you and others that have specific goals they want to achieve and finding ways that I can help them reach those goals. That has always been my passion and my dream. At first, it was in the language arts classroom, and now it's in the bigger, wider picture of the whole school.
Okay. And what is it like being the principal here after like being around in the community for so long?
Well, at first it was a little interesting, but I became a teacher here after I went to high school here. So I had to figure out how to work with my former teachers as my colleagues. And now some of those same teachers are now working on my staff, and I don't consider myself a boss as much as I do a facilitator for them, to make sure that they have what they need to be successful in their jobs and their roles. But I think the hardest thing for me was just the transition from student to staff to then facilitator for them.
That makes sense. What is your educational background?
I graduated from Covington in 1996, and I went to Covington my entire school career. I then took a year off to work and decide what not to do with my life, which was work in a factory. Although that work is important, it wasn't for me. So I went back to college at Wright State and got my bachelor's degree in 2002. I had no intention of coming back to Covington, but there was an opening, and the teacher that inspired me to become a teacher was the one who reached out to me and asked me to come in and interview. And she inspired me then to take that role, and I did. And I've been here ever since, so this is my 22nd year at Covington. And I got my master's degree in principal's license in 2018.
Okay. So far, what have been your biggest challenges with being the principal here?
I think it's balancing my time. The hardest part is making sure that I am effectively leading the school community, but also effectively being a mother, because I have two children in the school, and effectively being a wife and a daughter and a friend, you know, just making sure that I can be successful in all the different important roles in my life. That was a real important thing for me. So I think that's been my biggest challenge.
What like sports and athletics are you most excited to see this year?
I love watching our Buccaneers do everything, but some of the things I'm especially interested in going to this year are band events. I love going to watch our marching band at their contests. I really love watching I love cross country meets. I'm a big fan. Being outside is nice. And you get to see them like run by and then run by again. And you got to like run from one place to another. That's a lot of fun. I'm not going to choose any favorites, but I really love watching volleyball. But I'm also a big fan of our outdoor sports, so I will be looking forward to baseball and softball in the spring and track.
Yeah, I can't say I'm much of a fan of running myself, but next weekend, next Saturday, that's our first competition.
Okay.
So that's going to be interesting.
Yeah, yep.
Are there any new programs this year for the high school?
One new program is extended school. We noticed that we have some students who are struggling to stay ahead in their homework for whatever reason. Maybe it's because they haven't figured out how to manage their time yet. We already had our VIP program in place to help students during study halls, but what we were finding is that they're spending study hall after study hall and they're working on things. And we thought, what if we gave them an opportunity after school to get that work done. So we added extended school. It's on Tuesday and Thursday. And if there are students struggling to get work done, we just ask them to stay so they have a little bit more focused time to get those things done. And we also have students who don't have study halls who now have an opportunity to get tutoring after school during that extended school time.
All right, that sounds interesting. So are there any field trips that the students can look forward to this year?
Yes, so we have a field trip coming up in September to see a speaker named Kevin Hines. That's being sponsored by our Hope Squad. So our Hope Squad is going, and I think a total of about 45 students. And he's a motivational speaker that we're really interested in sending our students to. And then as far as other field trips go, right now we're still working out some of the details for later in the school year. So lots of things to look forward to.
Who's your favorite student in the high school?
Oh boy, that's really hard. I'm feeling a lot of pressure to say some certain ones who might be in this room, Pax. I actually do not have any favorites. I actually had a conversation yesterday with a student, and I told that student, you know, I really care about you and all of the students. And that person said to me, we know you love us. And so I hope that you do know, because I do care about all of you.
That's a great answer. Overall, what are some of your goals for the students this year to accomplish?
Well, I think that depends on the student. Whatever it is that they are striving for, I hope that I can help them find ways to be successful. I certainly want every student to graduate and to be the best version of themselves that they can be. And that includes being kind and respectful and responsible. Those are things that you're gonna need in real life. So I don't necessarily need everyone to be stellar at everything, but if each person can achieve their personal goal and I can play a role in that in whatever small way, then I'll be happy.
All right, well, thank you for your time. Is there anything else you'd like to say?
Go Bucks.
Go Bucks.
Hi, I'm Carter Lane, and we're here with Mrs. Downs. Are you excited for this school year?
I am very excited for this school year. It's year two. It's got to be easier than year one.
What do you love most about working at Covington?
So just living here, being in the community, our daughter's going to go to this school, so being part of where she's going to grow up is really important to me.
What is your educational background like?
So, I graduated from Ansonia High School, so size-wise, comparable to Covington. Got my undergrad degree at Defiance College, my master's at Concordia of Chicago. I taught at PICWA for 10 years before coming here, so a lot of experiences in a lot of different areas and backgrounds.
What is the biggest challenge of being the middle school principal?
Honestly, the kids, and what I mean by that is all of our students are so different, and now that there are three grade levels, those differences are even more so. What works for child A won't work for child B, and definitely doesn't work for child C. So it's constantly being flexible, especially with this age group, because they change so much over the course of a school year.
What athletics are you excited to see this year?
So I'm a little biased towards cross country and track, because that's what I did through school, and knowing how successful some of our runners have been in the past, it's going to be really neat to see them continue on.
How's it like working with Mr. Downs?
It's the worst part of my job, actually. We've always talked about we see each other significantly more just because we're both in the building for an hour, whereas when I was at PICWA, we didn't have that hour. And if I'm going to sporting events, our daughter comes with me and our family is able to be there together and have dinner together at the concession stand.
Are there any new programs this year for the middle school?
Yeah, so we are hoping to have a middle school art club this year, which we have not had in the past. So that's mostly due to Mrs. Gerlach bringing that in now that we have 6th, 7th, and 8th graders. And we're also hoping to get a couple of other things started yet, but I don't want to introduce them in case they don't work out. I don't want people to get their hopes up.
What are some field trips the students can look forward to this year?
Oh, goodness. So the 8th grade girls will be going to Edison in November for the Women in STEM Conference, so we're really excited about that. We are hoping, keywords, hoping, to take some of our middle school kids to Columbus this year to visit the planetarium on OSU's campus. And I'm hoping we can do some other Pride Bucks initiatives like we did last year, maybe ice skating again at Hobart. That one went over really well last year.
Who's your favorite student in the middle school?
I dislike all of them equally.
What is your goal for the students to accomplish this year?
Honestly, for all of our kids, I want them to be in a better place when they come here every day. And maybe that's socially, maybe that's academically, maybe that's in their athletics, but if we can actually just see growth from our kids, that's what I want to see for all of them.
Is there anything else you'd like to add?
I really do like all of you. I don't want you thinking I dislike you. Just depends on the day sometimes.
Go Bucks.
Go Bucks. Go Bucks.
All right, I'm Avery Gooding. I'm here with Mr. Long of the elementary school. Now, Mr. Long, how are you doing today?
I am doing awesome, young man.
That's good to hear. Now, what are you excited for about the school year?
So each year brings its own challenges and fun. So just excited to see how the kids have grown over the last school year. So it's fun to see how they've matured, what new things they come with, that comes with them. So we're a couple weeks into it now, and it's just fun seeing how the kids have grown up, you know, and again, their interests have changed, and so that stuff's fun to me.
That's good to hear. That makes sense. I like that. Now, what do you like most about working at Covington?
Well, I just love the students here. Been a part of this community all my life, so, but it's fun and fulfilling for me, especially now as an elementary school principal. When I get to see you guys walking around the high school and see how much, most of you have matured, some of you have not, but I'm just kidding. But it's fun seeing our high school kids and the avenues and stuff that they're choosing right now, and watching them become adults, because I get to see them really little over there, and then you guys grow up, and all of the elementary teachers are just amazed about. They're like, oh my gosh, have you seen Avery Gooding? He's what a great kid, and he was such a stinker when he was little. I'm just kidding.
Yeah, I was. I don't blame them. Now, what is it like after being the principal here for a while?
So it's good, but you would think every year I think, man, it's going to be easier this year. I really know what I'm doing. But as I said earlier, each year is different, brings new challenges. Kids always are amazingly bring new challenges. So every year is new, and it's a learning experience, really. You figure one thing out, and whether it be academically or behaviorally, you've got to find new ways to work with kids and do what's best for kids all the time. So.
Yeah. And what is your educational background like?
So I went to school here, went on to Wright State, and then went to UD for my master's.
Nice. That's the University of Dayton, right?
That is correct.
All right. And what's the biggest challenge of being the elementary school principal?
I think each year I've been over there, it's been a little more challenging. It just seems like our kids come to school with a lot of stuff, you know, so they have a lot of challenges at home. So our goal really over there is, I want to say that they learn accidentally, you know, so we want it to be a safe place and just a place that they love to be, but that they love to come to. So. Some kiddos, this is the best place that they are at all day long. So that is our goal, to make it like that every day, you know. So I'm not sure if that answered your question or not. But.
I think it answers it pretty well. Now, what athletics are you excited to see this year, just to watch in general?
Cross country, of course. But I love all of our sports. I get to as many as I can. Obviously I coach that. Love to see, you know, our kids right now, when I just look at our fall sports, everybody's working so hard, you know, and everybody wants to have an undefeated season or whatever it may be, but it's just fun watching our kids here at Covington, the ones that are involved, working hard, you know, and then seeing improvement. And sometimes that's through wins and losses, sometimes it's just through their own individual success. But I just love all of our athletics, always have.
Yeah, personally, I'm a huge fan of cross country too, and track this year.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Great. Yeah. And what are there any new programs in the elementary school that the kids should look forward to?
Well, one that's going to be continued is the LifeWise program. So we started that last year, and it's ran by a separate entity, but, you know, so that is our Bible-based character ed study. So we had, right now, going into the year, we start next week, and we have 100 kids that will be doing that through the week. I just think that's a good opportunity for kids. You know, we got exposed some kids to things they wouldn't be exposed to outside of school. So, and again, that's parental choice. So if they want to do it, they can. But we got a lot of other good things going on there. Mr. Gerlach does a great job with our student council and all of our clubs as far as art club, math club, and different things like that. Girls club, all those clubs are good that are just awesome over at the elementary.
That sounds like some great opportunities they can have. That sounds great. And are there some field trips that students can look forward to this year?
Well, we got some that are starting to become annual. Last year we had each grade took one to two field trips. So we amped that up in the last couple of years. That thanks to our BEST, they pretty much have funded all of our field trips. BEST was our PTO, but it's got a new name now. So, but they do a great job raising money so our kids can go on field trips. Right now, the first one that some kids will have the opportunity on is our fundraiser for the walkathon. So if the kids raise like $50, we're taking them skating during the day, which will be pretty cool. So we'll find out how many kids are going to get to go to that next week. Hopefully about 360 of them, so which is a lot, but that'd be a lot of money too.
Yeah, that is a lot, and that's a good thing they can do. I like that. Now, here's a good question for you. Who is your favorite student in the elementary school?
Well, that's not really fair to answer, Avery. I can't do that.
Makes sense.
I would have to probably say my daughter, because if she'd ever see this, but I love them all, okay? And obviously the ones I get to build relationships with are in my office a lot. So so my favorite may not be somebody else's, but I truly like them all. And like I said, they're all unique, and they all bring different things to the table. So I love all of our kiddos.
Yeah, I like that. No personal favorites. We will. No. Yeah. I like that. And finally, what are some goals for the students to accomplish this year?
Well, just come to school and have fun, okay? And like I said, you know, and obviously we're going to be learning, but like ideally within our classroom environments, they're purely learning by accident a lot of times, you know. So if they're engaged and doing fun activities that helps them learn academically. So for us, so much of it is social and emotional. And if you're happy, you're going to learn. And that's our goal down there. So we, you know, obviously they've got homework and they've got stuff, but like it's to make sure it's a place where they want to come and learn, you know, and then really our job is to learn.
Yeah, I like that. And now finally, anything you want to say to the camera before we cut here?
Go Bucks.
Go Bucks.